Hi friends, I welcome all of you to another video of Theory of Structure 1 lecture series. So in our previous sessions, we've mainly discussed about the concept like identify the various types of forces, state the principle of moments, calculate the moment of forces like a point load, uniformly distributed load and a uniformly varying load, and calculate the support reaction in a simply supported beam and overhanging beam. So in our today's discussion will be geometrical properties of a sections like a centroid and a center of gravity. Let's start our section. So all of you heard about the term centroid and center of gravity, right? So you may be studied about this concept in your plus two classes and also first year diploma classes. In our sections, we will discuss the centroid and center of gravity of the body or a plane figure in a detail. So center of gravity of a body is the point through which the whole weight of a body is assumed to be, and the peculiarity of this center of gravity is that it doesn't change with the position of the body. So when the body is horizontal, vertical or in aligned position, the center of gravity doesn't change, and we used it to demarcate this center of gravity by CG or G. So next we will see the centroid. Centroid is a point at which the total area of the plane figure is assumed to be concentrated, and it is also marked as CG or G. So in a summary, we can say that both the terms are represented in the same concept, but only difference is that the center of gravity is defined for a 3D body and the centroid is defined for a plane figure. So in a plane figure, the total area is assumed to be concentrated at the centroid, and the total weight of the body is assumed to be concentrated in a point called a center of gravity. So now we will discuss the centroid of some simple figures like a square. So square having a side A have the centroid by the intersection of the diagonals or the intersection of the midpoint. So you can easily find the centroid of a square by axis joining the midpoint. It is an intersection point of the mid axis. Similarly, for the rectangles also, it is the intersection of the diagonals or the intersection of the mid axis, and you can find the area of the square as a square and the area of the rectangle as AB. And the parallelogram also, we can have the mid axis or the diagonal intersection as the centroid. And next we have a new figure called a trapezium or trapezoid. Trapezoid is a figure which is having two parallel axes. So the sides are parallel, having side A and B respectively. So we need to find the area and the centroid of this figure. So area of this figure will be the average of the sides into the perpendicular height. That is A plus B by 2 into H will be the area of this trapezium, and centroid of this plane figure from the base equal to B plus 2A, that is B plus 2A divided by A plus B into H by 3. This will be the centroid of the figure from the base B. If we need to find the centroid from the top, that is A, that value will be A plus 2B divided by A plus B into H by 3. In this figure, it is B plus 2A divided by A plus B into H by 3. Next one is a circle. Centroid of the circle will be always at the center, and the circle is having a radius R. So the area of the circle is pi r square, or in terms of diameter it is pi by 4 d square. Next we have a triangle. Triangle of base B and height h. So the area of the triangle is half into b into h, and the centroid of the triangle will be in this axis at a distance h by 3 from the base. The next we have a semicircle. Semicircle is the half of a circle which is having a radius r. So the area of the semicircle will be half of that of a circle, that is pi r square by 2, and centroid of this semicircle from the base will be 4 r by 3 pi. So this distance will be 4 r by 3 pi. R will be the radius of the circle. So far we discussed about the centroid of plane figure having simple shape. Now we are going to develop an expression or an equation which is applicable to all figure to find the centroid. We have plane figure which is like an elliptical shape. So we can have any shape. It is not necessary to have an elliptical shape. So we have an irregular shape. Total area of this plane figure is capital A, and the total area is divided into a number of vertical strips having small area A1, A2, A3, etc. And we have two axes, that is OX and OY axis. From the reference axis OY, the centroidal distance of individual elemental area are x1, x2, x3, x4, etc. And centroid of this full figure from the reference line OY will be x bar. So total area is capital A and total centroid distance is x bar. So first we have the expression capital A is equal to individual sum of the elemental area, and the x1, x2, x3 are the centroidal distance of elemental area from the reference axis OY. Now we are going to take the moment of this elemental area about the reference axis OY. So we get the sum of the moments is A1 into x1 plus A2 into x2 plus A3 into x3, etc., and so on. And next we have the moment of this total area about the OY axis. So that is total area of this plane figure is capital A multiplied by the centroid of this plane figure from the OY is x bar. So now we know that the moment of all areas about the OY must be equal to the moment of total area about the same axis. So equating the equations 1 and 2, we get A1 x1 plus A2 x2 etc. equal to A x bar. From that we can find the x bar as A1 x1 plus A2 x2 plus A3 x3 etc. divided by the total area, that is A1 plus A2 plus A3. Similarly, we can consider a number of horizontal strips having individual area A1, A2, A3 etc. and centroidal distance from the reference axis OX as Y1, Y2, Y3 and Y4 etc. and the centroid of the total area A from the OX is considered as Y bar, then the value of Y bar can be summarized as A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 plus A3 Y3 etc. divided by the total area A. So Y bar is the distance of centroid from the axis OX of Y1, Y2, Y3 are the distance of centroid of elemental area from the axis OX. So these two expressions will be our common interest. These equations are used to find the centroid of complex shape. So next we see the some important points regarding the centroid. The first point is the axis about which the moment of area is taken is known as the axis of reference. In the above article, the axis OX and OY are called the axis of reference. The second point is the axis of reference of the plane figure is generally taken as the lowest line of the figure for determining Y bar and left line of the figure for calculating x bar. You will understand that concept when we discuss a problem. Okay, next one. If the given section is symmetrical about the xx and yy axis, then the centroid of the section will be lie on the axis of symmetry. So that is we seen in the case of a rectangle, axis of symmetry in xx and yy direction, then their axis of intersection will be the centroid of the rectangle. A figure having axis of symmetry in both x and y direction, the centroid will be the intersection of the axis of symmetry. If it is having only one axis of symmetry, then the centroid will lie anywhere in that axis of symmetry. And the last point is the center of gravity of the section like a T section, I section, L section are obtained by splitting them into rectangular components. We will see this while discussing a problem. So our first problem is find the centroid of an angle section having dimension 100 mm by 80 mm into 20 mm. This is the dimension of the angle section, which means that 100 mm is length of one leg and 80 mm is length of another leg, and thickness of this angle section it is 20 mm. That is the meaning of 100 by 80 by 20 mm. So we need to find the centroid of this angle section. Okay, we need to find the x bar and y bar. So in order to find the centroid, we will consider initially the axis of reference. For finding the x bar, we need to consider the reference axis on the left hand side. So left hand side, we will consider the reference line for finding x bar, and we consider the lowest point on the section for finding y bar. So now we again divide the total L section into two individual rectangles. Now we are considering section 1 as this rectangle and section 2 as this rectangle. So when you first consider the rectangle 1, so area of this rectangle is 100 into 20 mm. So A into B will be the area of the rectangle, and x1 is the centroid distance from the reference y axis. Okay, so x1 will be the half of this 20 mm. So midsection will be the centroid x1. So that is equal to 20 by 2, that is 10 mm. And y1 is the centroid of this section 1 from the horizontal reference axis. So horizontal reference axis is considered at this lowest line. So from this, the half distance, that is 100 by 2, 50 mm will be the y1. First rectangle, we find the x1 and y1. So now we consider the second rectangle. So second rectangle equal A2 equal to this much area. So we have considered 80 mm as the total length. So we need to only consider this much distance. So 80 minus 20, this is 60 only. So 60 into 20 mm, that will be the area of the second rectangle. And x2 is the centroid of this rectangle about this reference axis. The reference axis will be the left end of the section. So about this line, we need to find the centroid. So we know that for this rectangle, from this side we have a x bar as 60 by 2, that is 60 by 2, 30 mm plus this distance. So that will be the x2 distance. So x2 will be the centroid of the second rectangle about the reference axis, that is 20 plus 60 by 2, that is total 50 mm we get. And y2 is the centroid of the second rectangle from the horizontal reference axis. So that will be 20 by 2, that is 10 mm. So if we find these values, we can easily find the centroid of this figure. First we will find x bar. X bar will be the total centroid of this plane figure about the vertical reference axis. X bar equal to a1 x1 plus a2 x2 divided by a1 plus a2. So a1 we've already found 2000 into x1 is 10 mm, and a2 is 1200 mm into x2 is 50 mm. Again a1 plus a2 will be the sum of the areas of 1 and 2. We get 25 mm as the total x bar, that is the centroidal distance about the vertical reference axis. And next we will have the y bar, that is the centroidal distance from the horizontal reference axis. So that is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 divided by a1 plus a2. Substituting these values, we get 35 mm as the vertical centroidal distance from the horizontal reference axis. Second question, find the centroid of 100 mm by 150 mm by 30 mm T section as shown in the figure. Okay, so here we have a T section. The breadth of the section is 100 mm and the depth of the section is 150 mm. The thickness of the T section is 30 mm. So we need to find the centroid. So first thing, we need to find the axis of reference. So we have already studied, if a section is having an axis of symmetry in the both direction, then the centroid will be the intersection of this axis of symmetry. For this T section, we have an axis of symmetry in YY. About this section, the both sides are symmetrical. Our centroid will be anywhere in the line YY. So we need to find only the distance from which the centroid is from the horizontal reference axis. Similar to the first problem, we will consider first rectangle, that is ABCH. ABCH is taken. So the area of the first rectangle is 100 into 30, that is 3000 mm square. So in this problem, we only need to find the y bar distance, that is the distance of the centroid from the horizontal reference axis. So for the individual area also, we need to find y1, y2 only. No need to find x1 and x2. So y1 is the centroid of the first figure from the baseline. Centroidal distance of the first area from the base will be y1. So we know that the 150 is the total depth of the section. So 150 minus 30 by 2, that half of the that rectangle, 30 mm will be the centroid of this first rectangle, and the distance of the centroid of the first rectangle from the base we consider as y1. So y1 is equal to 150 minus 30 by 2, that is equal to 135 mm. Similarly, we consider the next rectangle. that is rectangle DEFG. In that rectangle, we have the area A2 as 120, that is 150 minus 30 will be the depth of this rectangle. 120 into 30 will be the area of this rectangle, that is equal to 3600 mm square, and Y2 is the distance of the centroid of this rectangle from the base EF. So that distance will be the half of this depth, that will be 120 by 2, that is 60 mm. So now we need to find the total centroid T section about EF, that will be A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 divided by A1 plus A2. So that is equal to, first area is 3000 into 135 plus 3600 into 60 divided by sum of the area, that is 3000 plus 3600 equal to 94.1 mm. So in our first problem, we need to find both x bar and y bar, because it doesn't have any axis of symmetry for this L section. But in this figure, we have one axis of symmetry. So one axis of symmetry, that is centroid of this T section, will be somewhere in YY axis. So we need to find only the distance of the centroid in YY. Now we have another problem, that is find the centroid of a channel section as shown in the figure. So this is called a channel section or a C section, so which is having a dimension 50 mm width and 100 mm depth, and again thickness as 15 mm. So we need to find the centroid of this figure. Similar to the previous question, we first check whether the section having any axis of symmetry. So we know that the C section is symmetric about the horizontal axis, the XX axis. This is symmetrical. So we can conclude that the centroid of this entire C section will somewhere on this X axis. So in order to find that, take the vertical reference axis on the left hand side. On AC, we will consider the reference vertical axis. So about that vertical reference axis, we need to find the X bar of the C section. Similar to the previous problems, we divide the total area into three individual rectangles. Okay, first rectangle, if you consider, we have the area 50 into 15 mm, so 750 mm as the area, and x1, it is the distance of the first rectangle from the vertical reference axis, so that distance will be 50 by 2, that is 25 mm will be the centroid of the first rectangle from the vertical reference axis. And next we have the second rectangle, that is this one, and which is having an area, so we need to find the breadth into depth. So total area is given 100 mm, 100 minus this thickness and 15 mm thickness here, we will get a 70 mm as the depth of this rectangle and breadth as 15 mm. So we will get a A2 as 70 into 15, which is 1050 mm square, and X2 is the centroid distance of the second rectangle from the vertical reference axis considered at AC. So we have that value also. And third one, it is the rectangle CDHK. And we have the area as breadth into depth, that is 50 into 15 mm, and X3 as the centroid of the third rectangle from the vertical reference axis considered at AC, and that distance will be again 50 by 2, that is 25 mm. Now we need to find the X bar. X bar is equal to A1 X1 plus A2 X2 plus A3 X3 divided by sum of the area, 750 into 25 plus 1050 into 7.5 plus 750 into 25 divided by the sum of the area equal to 17.8 mm, which is the centroid of this C section about the vertical reference axis. Now we'll see another problem. A square hole is punched out of a circular lamina, the diagonal of the square being the radius of the circle as shown in the figure 6.22 and this figure, and find the center of gravity of the remainder if R is the radius of the circle. So we have a circle which is having a radius equal to R, and we are punching out a square of diagonal R from the circle. We need to find the centroid of the remaining area. So similar to the other problems, we first consider the reference axis. So we know that it is having an axis of symmetry in XX direction. In YY direction, there is no axis of symmetry. So XX axis or AB axis, we have an axis of symmetry. So the top and bottom portion are exactly symmetrical. our centroid will be somewhere around AB. We need only to find the distance x bar from the vertical reference axis considered at the left end of the figure. That is, at the point A, we consider a vertical reference axis, and from that we will find the distance x bar. That will be the centroid of the remaining plane figure. We consider first figure, that is the circle as 1, and we consider the square as second figure. So in a main circle, we have an area of the main circle as pi r square. So that is the area of the circle, and we have x1, that is the centroidal distance of the first area from the vertical reference axis. We know that the centroid is at the center, which is at a distance r from the vertical reference axis. And the second area is a square having the diagonal as r. So the area of this square will be half into d1 into d2. If the diagonals are d1 and d2, then the area of the square based on the diagonal is half into d1 into d2. So we get the area equal to half into r, that is 0.5 r square as the area of this square. Okay, and the x2 of this figure will be at a distance r by 2 from the center. So this point will be the centroid of the square, which is at a distance r plus r by 2 from the vertical reference axis. Okay, so we will consider x2 as r plus r by 2, that is 1.5 r from the vertical reference axis considered. Here one difference is that we are cutting some portion from the main figure, so we need to find the centroid of the remaining figure. So in that, our equation will be changed to this form as x bar equal to a1 x1, that is the area of the circle, into x1 bar minus a2, that is area of the square, into x2, divided by a1 minus a2. Okay, substituting the value, we get the expression like this. We get the result as shown here. We have another problem. In this, we have a trapezium. A semicircle of 90 mm radius is cut out from a trapezium as shown in the figure. So we have a trapezium having 200 mm as the top distance and 300 mm as the bottom distance. Height is 120 mm. We are cutting a semicircle from the trapezium and having a radius 90 mm. We need to find the centroid of the remaining section. So we will first check whether it is having any axis of symmetry, and we have the axis of symmetry in y direction. So our centroid will be somewhere in this y axis, and we need to find distance from the bottom reference axis considered at AB. So we need to find the y bar. We consider the trapezium as the first area and semicircle as the second area. In case of trapezium, A1 is equal to 200 plus 300 by 2 into height, that is 30,000 mm square. And the centroid from the base, we have 300 plus 2 times 200 divided by 300 plus 200 into h by 3. That is the centroid of the trapezium from the base. And we again have one semicircle. So semicircle case, the area is half of that of a circle, that is pi r square by 2. R is 90 mm, 4050 pi mm square. And y2 is the centroid of this semicircle from the horizontal reference axis considered at AB. Y2 is equal to 4r by 3 pi. 4r by 3 pi, r is the radius. Substituting this, we get 120 by pi mm. So if it is so, then we have the final expression for y bar as y bar is equal to a1 y1, that is area of the trapezium into the centroid distance of the trapezium minus area of the semicircle into centroid distance of the semicircle. A1 y1 minus a2 y2 divided by a1 minus a2. Substituting the value, we get the value as 69.1 mm.